I wasn't really supposed to be in the seat I was supposed to be in. I should have been behind a machine gun. I should have been in vehicle 1 or 4. I was in vehicle 3. They pre-detonated on us, so it blew up out in front of my Humvee. It actually still resulted in, you know, the loss of my leg. I was struck by a roadside bomb about 30 miles south of Baghdad. At the time, I was a private first class in the United States Marine Corps. And as a result of the roadside bomb, I lost my left leg. With retiring out of the Marine Corps earlier than I planned, I was given the choice to go back to school as a disabled veteran. When I began my job search, I hadn't known too much about the YMCA, so I kind of walked into the front desk and asked if they were hiring, and you know, kind of gave my sob story a little bit. So as I walked outside of the Y, I gave my mom a phone call and I said, well, I think I just got a job. At that point, I was approximately 285 to 290 pounds. My life was contained in one giant complacent bubble. January 1st of 2009, I decided to make my health my New Year's resolution. I lost some weight, I got a little bit happier, I started to do more things outside of the Y. I didn't use my amputation of my leg as an excuse. Next thing you know, I was happy with who I was and where I was at. It slowly became more of a occupation than just a part-time job. And I really started to enjoy it. I've now been employed full-time for approximately 8 months. Words don't describe it. How I felt at the lowest and how I feel now. I would not change a day of my life. Had it not been for the injuries I suffered in Iraq, I wouldn't be here. I'm the healthiest I've ever been. I love my job, I love the members, and ultimately, if you had to do it in one sentence, it would be as simple as the YMCA is not a gym, it is a community.